This is what you get by the end of this video. I will show you how to get NDS Emulator iOS 15 on iPhone or iPad. This is iNDS Emulator iOS 15, no revoke and no jailbreak method. So watch it till the end. Let's just start this process. We will use RStore to get iNDS Emulator iOS 15 for iPhone. As you can see, let me just show you. I am running iOS 15 on my device and I will download iNDS Emulator on iOS 15. First, we need to download iNDS Emulator IPA file. For that, go to this website. You will get the link below in this video's description. Go here, scroll down to the install iNDS Emulator section. It's a complete written guide to iNDS Emulator. Tap on this link. On the next page, just tap on the skip button at the top. Tap on download in the pop-up. It will start downloading iNDS Emulator IPA file. As you can see, the IPA file is downloaded. Now to install iNDS Emulator IPA file, we need to install the RStore on our device. If you already have the RStore on your device, just continue watching this video. But for those who don't have the RStore, installing RStore on Windows and on a Mac computer are two separate methods. Including both methods in this video would make this video too long. Therefore, I already have made two separate tutorials on installing RStore on Windows and on a Mac computer. I will put both videos link up in the cards and in the description below. You can watch those to install RStore and come back. As you can see, I already have installed the RStore on my device to get iNDS Emulator iOS 15 on my device. Once you got the RStore, open the RStore. If you are opening it for the first time, it will ask you to trust the app from the settings. After that, you will be able to open it. Open the RStore, go to My App section from the bottom. Tap on the plus icon at the top. This page will show you all of your downloaded IPA files. Just tap on the iNDS Emulator IPA file. It will start installing NDS Emulator on your device. Make sure your device is connected to the computer from where you install the RStore in your device. Now, if you are installing the IPA for the first time with the RStore, it will ask you to put in your Apple ID. Here, you need to put in the same Apple ID you entered while downloading the RStore in your device. Put in the credentials and proceed. iNDS Emulator iOS 15 will take just a little time to install. Guys, if you have made this far in this video, hit the like button, also the subscribe button for more iOS related videos. As you can see, it's installed now. I can use it to play games. Now for the games, you need to have the physical copy of the original game. Then on your computer, you can dump that to get the file to play on your device. It's the official method. I use this official method to get the game. You can use the same. Well, there might be any other ways to get around this as well, but I have no clue about that. Using the official method, once you have transferred the file in your device, go into the files folder. Here you will find the zip file. Tap and hold the zip file and tap on the share button. From here, tap on the more if you do not see the NDS Emulator on this list. Then tap on the iNDS Emulator icon. After that, just refresh this list or just open the emulator again. You will find the game here in this list. Tap on it, then tap on the launch to play the game. If you want to download GPA for iOS 15 emulator, I already have posted that video. I will put its link in the description below and up in the cards you can watch that. This is how to get iNDS Emulator for iPhone. Although this iNDS Emulator iOS 15 is no revoke method, but you do need to reset the expiry date after every 7 days for the RStore to keep using the NDS Emulator iOS 15 on your device. I have explained all these things in my RStore videos. When it's near to the expiring, all you need to do is to attach your device with the computer from where you installed the RStore. Make sure your device and your computer are attached to the same Wi-Fi network, and also make sure the R server is running on your computer. Then just press on the refresh all button. The NDS Emulator expiry date will go back to the 7 days again and you will be able to use it. Just in case you didn't reset the expiry date and it's expired, then all you need to do is to reinstall only the RStore. All the sideloaded apps including NDS Emulator will start working again. Just do not delete the iNDS emulator when all store expires, otherwise you will lose all the emulator data. Thank you for watching.